Today, watching PTS English News, I'm Ethan Liu. Children's mass vaccination sites remain open during the Dragon Boat Festival long weekend. The move, however, has been criticized by Taipei City government officials. Deputy Mayor Tsai Bing-kun said the city government hadn't been reached out by the central government before the policy was implemented.
Over the long weekend, parents in northern Taiwan brought their children to Chiang Kai-shek Memorial Hall to get vaccinated. Medical personnel hand out balloons to children to distract them from their fear of needles. The site opened on June 1st and administered just 369 and 468 shots, respectively, on the first 2 days. Officials say turnout of 1,500 is expected on the third day. 82 medical workers were assigned to the site on the first day, but the number was cut by half on the second day due to the low turnout on the first day and by 40% on the third day despite the much higher forecast. Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je says given the overall low turnout, the central government should close the site and stop wasting resources. Tsai Bing-kun says the central government unilaterally opened the site, and if it had bothered to coordinate with the city government beforehand, Taipei City would have recommended accelerating weekday campus vaccinations first and leaving mass vaccination sites for weekends. Tsai also said two of the city's four medical treatment and testing drive-throughs will be shut down on the third, but could be brought back if needed. One of the two remaining drive-throughs will be reduced from two lanes to one, and the future of the other is uncertain at this time.
Meanwhile, during his visit to Taichung, Premier Su said the central government's seven vaccination sites are well received and it helps greatly to relieve the burden for local authorities.
The large-scale vaccination site in Taichung was filled with parents and children on the first day of the Dragon Boat Festival holiday in the morning. The nurse tried to calm the child down to administer the shot. The process only took about a few seconds each, but some children got too flustered and needed more soothing. It was the third day of vaccination on the third, and even more parents brought their children to the Taichung National Museum of Natural Science for vaccination. Many parents brought their children to the government's vaccination site since they hoped to get their children vaccinated earlier. Premier Su Jin-chang and Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong arrived at the vaccination site at 8:30 a.m. to see how the procedures were going. Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je recently criticized the central government's move to set up more vaccination sites as unnecessary, since different cities are also administering vaccinations already. In response, Premier Su said 5,000 shots were administered in just 3 days in Taichung, which obviously helped to increase children's vaccination rate. Meanwhile, the KMT earlier demanded an investigation and prosecution of Legislative Deputy Speaker Tsai Chi-chang's assistant for allegedly spreading false information regarding the Taichung City government's children vaccination status. Premier Su said misunderstandings have been cleared. The Taichung Veterans General Hospital said they expect to administer up to 3,600 shots per day, which would greatly boost children's vaccination coverage.
According to a media report, a traditional Chinese medicine doctor was quoted by a source as saying Qingguan Yihao is in short supply and is not only available to certain age groups and people they haven't had three shots.
Qingguan Yihao is a traditional Chinese medicine formula developed to treat COVID-19. However, there have been reports that a TCM doctor is saying the formula is in short supply and can only be prescribed to people over 65 or under 12, or people who have not had 3 vaccine doses. The doctor was quoted as saying the policy punishes people who have had 3 shots.
新冠药本身这个药还是有点寒性啊，病人的症状整体上是不是最适合用新冠药，可以由中医师来做整体综合评估判断。
The Department of Chinese Medicine and Pharmacy says seniors, children, and people that haven't had 3 shots do get priority because they have a greater chance of severe symptoms, but that doesn't mean it's not available to everyone else. The department says the formula is not suitable for everyone and can only be prescribed by TCM doctors.
生产的能量要顾及品质，所以它目前我们已经把它开到最大限量，所以我们希望消费者不要囤积。
The Ministry of Health and Welfare says anyone that needs the formula can check the Qingguan Yihao platform to find out where to get it for free. The ministry estimates 3.5 million people will take Qingguan Yihao within 5 years because it is safe for patients of all ages and pregnant women as well.
Now, a few more stories from around Taiwan. Highway traffic's mostly smooth on the first day of the Dragon Boat Festival holidays, with some congestion seen on the Nangang System Interchange connecting to Highway No. 5. Traffic volume overall is 23% lower compared to last year. The 130 acres of trees will very likely be removed as the Taiwan Sugar Corporation land has been rented out to a renewable energy company for solar power development. Local residents worry the plan will actually damage the environment. Taiwan's Economic Affairs Minister Wang Meihua had a virtual meeting with the EU Director General for Trade, Sabine Wen, on June 2nd, signaling a great leap in the mutual relationship. A DPP city councillor to accuse Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je of running a cyber army. A PTT user recently posted about his whole family getting COVID-19 and not being able to get any help. The account was traced to a Taipei City Hall IP address.
查了之后是在台北市政府，怎么办？怎么处理？这个我们市政府里面有网军。A
Taipei City councillor accuses Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je of using a cyber army to sway public opinion during an interpellation. The ruckus started with this PTT post, in which a netizen said his family of 5 had all tested positive and that his wife was a moderate to severe case. The netizen criticized government for politicizing epidemic management and said it is impossible to get medical care unless one supports the right color. The IP address of the netizen was traced back to Taipei City Hall.
查询书清楚后，我们会再把报告给政风。什么时候嘛？一个期限嘛？大概下礼拜三。
On the 2nd, the Department of Information Technology said 3 PTT accounts, including the one that made the post, had been traced back to one person, a Taipei Expo Foundation employee surnamed Lin. The department says Lin did experience what he posted about and was just trying to blow off some steam.
这内容是属实啊，我们也可能理解说他在那个时候的一些心情。他犯错的地方其实是他不该在上班的时候去做不该非公务的事情。The
foundation says the employee did in fact test positive previously and his family members got infected as well. The foundation does not believe the employee had ill intent and says there is no City Hall cyber army. However, he should not have been posting from his personal account at work and will be punished for that.
Now, let's take a look at more international news today. On the first day to mark her Platinum Jubilee, Queen Elizabeth led a lighting of beacons from her Windsor Castle. Meanwhile, similar celebrations and firework displays were also seen across Britain and in the capital cities of Commonwealth countries. Marvel's new TV show Ms. Marvel has been touted as groundbreaking as it focuses on the studio's first Muslim superhero Kamala Khan, a Pakistani-American teenage girl. Ukraine has earned a place in the World Cup finals for just the second time as an independent nation after they beat Scotland 3-1 in the qualification playoff. Even soldiers pay attention to the game amid the war with Russia and cheer for their team. The United States Department of State made 2 revisions on the fact sheet dealing with U.S.-Taiwan relations within the month. It was suspected of being due to pressure from China.
It has come to the attention of many when the United States State Department removed statements saying that Taiwan is a part of China and that the U.S. does not support Taiwan's independence on its U.S. Relations with Taiwan official webpage on May 5th. However, after U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken's speech on May 26th about the U.S. approach towards China, the phrase that the U.S. does not support Taiwan's independence was put back on the webpage on the 28th. Many wondered if the latest update was a response to China's protest. One scholar shared his thoughts, saying that the U.S. State Department held a firm stance when they made the change on the 5th, but the quick revision after definitely leads people into making that assumption. Taiwan's former foreign minister Chen Jianren said that the U.S. always adjusts its saying for different purposes, but the general direction remains the same. A spokesperson of the State Department, who asked not to be named, said the revision was to reflect Blinken's speech and denied that it was made in response to China's protests. The U.S. enjoys a strong unofficial relationship with Taiwan, he said. The U.S. and Taiwan announced the U.S.-Taiwan Initiative on 21st Century Trade on June 1st, in which Taiwan's government says is a recognition of the key position the island plays in global supply chains. China also firmly opposes the new trade initiative. The U.S. State Department reiterated its One China policy.
I can't speak to the PRC's reaction. What I can say is that everything we do in the context of our unofficial relationship with Taiwan is done pursuant to our longstanding One China policy.
U.S. State Department spokesperson Ned Price said a physical meeting would be held in Washington and it would help to negotiate for a roadmap to open up space for more trade and economic cooperation between the U.S. and Taiwan. Most Congress members are in support of the new trade initiative. However, U.S. Senator Pat Toomey expressed concerns about the lack of market access provisions in the initiative, which would limit the benefits for all. He introduced a Senate resolution detailing the need for a comprehensive trade agreement with Taiwan.
Thank you for watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu, and I will see you next time.